True Believers, this is Rob coming at you with a new video. And this video is going to be on, obviously as you can see, Star Wars Black Series, Force Awakens, First Order Stormtrooper, and Kylo Ren. Yay, I finally got these two guys. Actually, I had them in my possession for a while. I haven't really touched on going to do this video for the channel, so, not really high on this particular wave. I think they call it Phase 3 of the Star Wars Black Series, if that's what I understand it's being called. There's the original phase with the orange lights on the box, and then the blue lights, and now the Force Awakens waves. There is a fourth phase coming up, which is a mixture of Force Awakens and prequels and original trilogy characters. So, and this particular phase, I'm not high on all the figures, so I'm not interested in really picking up all the figures. Before the original two phases, I'm really interested in all the figures, but this phase, I'm just in a couple particular figures. Like for this, and I got two of them, and there's one more figure that I want to get, but it's really, really hard, and I'll go into it later, I guess. I'll go into it later, but let's talk about these two particular figures in more detail. First, we'll start off with the First Order Stormtrooper, and it's also says in French there, du premier ordre, I don't know, I can say it, but the packaging, it's a little different compared to the other Black Series, the first two phases Black Series figures. They didn't have that little image here of the character. It's, I'm not sure if this was on there, but... So then the sides are numbered. This is number 4 on this, it's basically the Force Awakens way, in my viewpoint. There's some info on the character itself. Pretty cool on the side. I actually found this guy at a Walgreens. I just walked into a Walgreens one night and they had this particular figure. That's pretty much the best place you're gonna find stuff for Black Series figures, is like Walgreens. If you find it at Target or Toys R Us, if it's not anything else different besides Finn or some of those characters nobody wants, you're lucky. This is really, really hard to pick up right now. It's just super competitive. But if you online, it's not as hard, but it's just, you pay a little more. But to buy off the rack, it's pretty hard. So let's crack this guy open, see how it looks out of the packaging. Okay, he's out of the packaging. First impressions is he's a solid figure. Not great. I don't know the reason that I get that impression when I just get it out of the box and I start playing with it. I don't know, it just seems like the quality has gone down from compared to those last two faces. I don't know, this particular figure to me, it's not the best. Although the Stormtroopers are, I think, a better quality and have more detail to them and just work more properly. This guy is kind of stiff. His joints are kind of weird. They don't move really well, but it's okay. Bow-legged. I can fix that, but I'm not happy. This weapon here, try to fit in this hand, and it's not really. I don't know. Maybe it's, you know, user's fault, but I can't really. It's not holding properly, and it's kind of weird looking, and this one's kind of loose as well on this, in this hand. So I wish he had like little pouches and stuff you actually store these weapons and holsters and stuff like that. He doesn't come with a holster. I would assume he would have a holster, but I guess not. The weight's great, it's fine. It's like mostly the figure to me is like, eh. I prefer the other regular Stormtrooper, the two Sand Troopers that come before it, the other phases. Much better, I think, figures. This one's okay, so.
we'll move on to Kylo Ren.
Kylo Ren's packaging is pretty much the same as the Stormtrooper, just with his illustration there on the front. He's number 3 on this wave, and here's the back. One of the more cooler characters in the film. Seen the film already twice. There is this little window on top as well. And the bottom, just a bunch of random information. But who cares about the packaging? Let's take him out of the packaging. Okie doke, got him out of the packaging. First impressions is he's better than the Stormtrooper. It's not the best figure they've done. I do like the material on his cloak, or I don't even call this, but yeah, it's called a cloak for now. This one part is plastic, right? This little like shawl thing. Nice weight to him. His ankles are a little loose. The joints are a little loose, but it's not bad. And the lightsaber, yeah, it's okay. I prefer the lightsabers he used than with the other figures, the translucent material. They're using like different materials for these particular waves. I don't know, just the qualities seem as good as the other figures. Maybe I'm tripping, I don't know just something about them. I can't put my finger on them. It just doesn't seem like they're as good as the other figures. This is, of course, a very difficult figure to get as well, same as the Stormtrooper. From 1 to 10, and there's some 10s in this line, I think, for 6-inch figures. I would give Kylo probably 7. He's good. A pretty good figure. Not great, but it's decent. It'll go nice with my collection. And let's bring in Captain Phasma. The Stormtrooper in with his little weapon. So, it's pretty much, I got him out of the packaging and the first, it's just like, not super impressed with the figures, but they're all right. Articulation is pretty basic. Ankles on both figures are a little loose. Not impressed with the weapons. They're kind of, I don't know, they're just not kind of formed right to the actual figures. And I prefer the materials they used on the lightsaber for the other lightsabers, not this one. The Stormtrooper, so I don't know, something about him. I'm trying to figure out what. I guess he's okay. Something just. Oh, it seems like maybe the paint's cheap or something. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being crazy here. But they're okay. It's, you know, $20 figure. I paid a little extra for this guy because I picked him up from Hasbro website. I had a order to the website. It cost me with shipping and taxes like $20. So, oh well. I wanted him. There's one more figure I really, really want. And he's super hard to get and he's really expensive now. It's Captain Phasma. He is hard to find and just difficult to get at a reasonable price. I'm not paying $40 to $50 for Phasma. The most I'll do is $30. That's after taxes and if shipping has to happen. But I'm going to look for him, keep trying. But sooner or later I'll get him. For now I have the Stormtrooper and Kylo. There is some other interesting figures coming out in the waves, in the next waves of the Force Awakens phase. For this particular first wave of figures, it's just these two and Captain Phasma really interested in. The rest are kind of just shit, honestly. And I have no interest in them. I did pick up another figure that's on its way. I bought it from the Hasbro website. It's the Han Solo and Tauntaun combo figure. And another Marvel Spider-Verse figure on that order. I should put up a video for those maybe within a week or two. I'm not sure, but we'll see. I got a couple of videos to do while I'm recording this, so you should see some stuff coming up on my channel here soon. Alright, so yeah. Do I highly recommend these? No. But people are going, they're sought after because just cool characters in the film, and like I said, I saw the film twice. Badass film, I think. I loved it. Looking forward to the next one. I got pushed to December of 2017. Looking forward Looking forward to that next anthology film comes out this year in December, Rogue One. That's gonna be cool. So yeah, that's that. So like the video if you liked it, subscribe to the channel, and keep on being troopers, keep on collecting. See you later. Bye.